Since it's the new year, I decided I wanted to start taking my New Year's resolutions more seriously. Here's a list of what I have so far. 1. Work out 3 to 4 times a week. 2. Eat healthier. 3. Take more pictures on my Canon AE-1. 4. Make time for some self-care. I'm honestly not that excited for the new year. Senior year is going to be a pain in my ass. Let's just hope I can survive this last semester of school. Wishing you the best. Love, your best friend, Rosie.
Hey, sorry I'm late. I was taking a shower.
Mm-hmm. That was a terrible lie. You went to smoke, didn't you?
What? No. Why? Does it look like I was?
Yeah, you look really high. I can smell it on you, too. When I tell you about that, I don't like when you smoke. You come in, stinks up my whole car. My parents will kill me if they smell it.
Look, I'm sorry. You just know that I needed to do it because I have my crim test coming up on Monday.
Yeah, so I don't like you doing it, especially when we're just about to go out.
It's fine. I'm more rambunctious when I'm high. We'll have a good time.
Oh, I think that's a good thing.
I'm sorry. To make up for it, I mean, I can get you some boba tea for your birthday.
All right.
Hey, actually, Rosie, can we just sit here and talk for a little bit?
Yeah, sure. You know, I always really appreciate you, like, sticking by me.
What makes you say that?
I don't know. It's just, like, I know you're going through, like, a really hard time right now. Normal people wouldn't stick by their friends, but, like, you always stick by me. So, I really appreciate that, you know?
You know, I kind of feel like I should be saying these things to you where it's your birthday.
Yeah, I know. But, like, it's not a big deal. And also, I never really enjoyed celebrating my own birthday. I kind of get, like, the birthday blues. But, like, I don't get them when I'm with you. So, like, that's nice.
Me too. Okay, but don't feel bad for me. James was a jerk anyways. He was always mean, he's not very good looking, and honestly, he was really bad at sex. I'm glad he broke up with me. He saved me months of bad sex.
Yeah, you really dodged a bullet with that one. That one was bad.
Yeah.
I know. Like, everybody says that when they break up with someone. Like, oh god, my dating history is literally terrible. I mean, do you remember that guy? What's his name? Whatever, that guy who had, like, the huge gauges in his ears, and then he had his hair, and he just drenched it with hairspray and stuck it straight up, and, like, no wind or nothing, not even, like, a bird flying into his head could mess up that piece of brick that he called hair. It was, oh my god.
Yeah, that was the fucking worst. You definitely win with bad taste in men.
Okay, we just have different tastes in men. My taste in men isn't bad, because at least my taste in men are good at having sex.
Oh. Your taste in them. Ha ha. Very funny. Yeah, I know.
So wrong. One man great, so they gotta be great. Woo! I just took a DNA test, turns out I'm 100% that bitch. Even when I'm crying crazy, yeah, I got boy problems, that's the human in me. Bling, bling, then I saw them, that's the goddess.
You could've had a bad bitch, not committal. Help you with your career, just a little.
Been traveling these wide roads for so long. My heart's been far from you, 10,000 miles gone. Oh, I wanna come near and...
Dear Daisy, it's already been a month of this new year, new me kind of crap, and I'm already so tired. I'm somehow surprised I've been keeping up a routine for a whole month. I know I have to keep going for my own sanity, because if I stop now, I know I won't be able to continue these resolutions. I've been trying to force myself to work out almost every day. It's always a struggle trying to keep up with schoolwork. Valentine's Day is today. I see all the couples' posts on Instagrams. If I see another post, I think I'm definitely going to vomit. You know what my mom always says. Valentine's Day is a fake holiday to express their affection with greetings and gifts. Like, why can't anyone do that another day? Why does it always have to be today? It just makes everyone who is single, lonely pieces of shit, and I'm one of them. I can already hear you laughing in my head and saying, actually, that makes two single, lonely pieces of shit, in your hilarious way. Anyways, I'm getting tired. I should probably start doing some homework. I'll write you again soon. Love, Rosie.
Why didn't you write me? Why? It wasn't over for me. I waited for you for 7 years. Now it's too late.
I wrote you 365 letters. I wrote you every day for a year.
You wrote me?
Yes. It wasn't over.
I'm sorry, but no one has the time to write a letter every single day. I mean, I can't even remember to do my homework every day.
I know, right? Like, ain't nobody got time for that.
Seriously, the men in romance movies are so unrealistic. The only chivalrous thing a guy's done for me is compliment my ass. And I mean,
I do have a good looking ass.
I mean, you know, you really do. You know, I strive to have an ass like yours.
Wait, thank you. And I thank you for joining me on this Valentine's Day tradition. So, I kind of got you something.
What's the point of this whole tradition? With no gifts, because it defeats the purpose of our dislike for this holiday.
Yes, yes, I know, but I figured, why not get you something nice on a day that we both hate? Just to remind you, you're not the only lonely piece of shit out there.
Oh my god. I love it.
But you know, you really didn't have to.
No, I know. But I figured, why not get you something on a holiday we both hate?
Oh, how charming. No fair. You've beaten me like 3 times.
Because I am a beast at this game. I am the king of all wars.
Okay, I think we should play something different since you are literally kicking my ass.
Why? Are you being a loser?
No. I just think that you should slow down.
Give it back!
No, okay, you've had plenty already.
Oh, you are being a meanie.
Hey, I'm just trying to look out for you.
I know, you're just being a drunk mom that just takes care of me.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, before I forget, I have an early Christmas gift for you that I kind of want to give to you.
Oh, I haven't even started my Christmas shopping yet.
I know, but I wanted to give it to you now. I just can't wait. Mm-hmm. Be careful, it's heavy.
No fucking way. Where did you find this?
At the local garbage disposal, you know, the one where you can trade in garbage for you know, other things. I got it since you're an English major and I figured you could write on it.
And it still works. So cool. I love it, Daisy. Thank you so much for this.
I'm glad you love it. It was either this or, you know, those fuzzy socks I get you every Christmas.
Yeah, I would definitely rather this over fuzzy socks.
I figured.
Okay. All right, we should probably go to bed because it's wicked, wicked late. It's like 3 a.m. So you can take my bed. I'm going to sleep in the common area. Okay? All
right. Hey, wait a second. Before you go, just know that I love you, Rosie, and I mean it. Just know that you've been a really great best friend and that I've never mean to hurt you.
What's going on?
I just wanted you to know that I love you so much and that you've been the best, best friend ever.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You didn't know that you can talk to me.
I know.
Okay. Do you want to talk about it?
No. Everything's fine.
Okay, so I'm here. If you ever want to talk.
Thanks. Good night, Rosie. Yeah.
Good night, Daisy.
Ask you to come here and do this?
Oh, no. First, I have to get you to agree. Then we'll see if she wants to come back.
Wow, that is tempting.
Dear Daisy, month 3, and I've already seen some progress in the way my body looks. You could say I might have a bigger ass than you. But seriously, though, I'm not gonna lie. This whole New Year's resolution shit is exhausting. I haven't totally been consistent. I've had a few off days. It pains me that graduation is only a month away and you won't be standing right beside me. I miss you. I've been trying to get out more. I've been running a lot and taking all sorts of photos that remind me of you. I just want you to know, I wish I could have done more to ease your pain. I remember that you told me that you wouldn't hurt me intentionally, but this hurts so fucking much. Why couldn't you have just shared your demons with me? I just wish you would have told me. Now I'm too late and you're gone. I know I'll be okay. I've been trying to be okay ever since the night of New Year's Eve. I just miss you so much. Just know that not a day goes by when I don't think of you. Love, your best friend, Rosie. We did it, Daisy. We graduated.